Hey, how you doing? Let's do it to it. Let's see, what do we want to do? 3 minutes, 5 minutes. Do a survival. Let me see here. There we go. Oh. So if I take here, he takes there. I take there. I take here, he takes there. We take there as mate. Okay. there. That's interesting. And I think wins a piece. Check. Check. Comes back, check. Comes there, and then we rip it off, okay. Trying to figure this one. This one's a little tougher. See, I'm thinking here, there, 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 here, here. Here, 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 there, there, maybe that, Let's try this here, there. Thinking if I turn it into a knight. And if he, oops. Turn into a knight, a king there. I could turn into a queen. Trying to think here. Ah, queen here threatens a knight and threatens mate. See, knight takes, and the problem with knight takes here. Rook takes, king takes. I think it's a draw. I'm wondering if rook check here, double exclam, or exclam, rook takes, king can't go here. Well, he could go there, and then I grab that. Yep, this is it. See here. So check. Say queen takes here, comes up there, knight there, and we have a threat here. Still like this. Knight here, threat's mate, so then when queen goes there, knight there, queen takes. I got it. Bishop takes. Takes queen here. Yep. Oh no! So close. Too fast. So close. Interesting thing is pawn before and passing push check king there. Oh, what did I miss? Come on, let's not start down this road. We need to get. We want to get at least another couple, so just chill and chill. I think we have perpetual. Oh. At the end, 24th. See? 24th. So close. It's doing so good. I don't know what went wrong here. We can't get there. Oh, I didn't see that. So if Queen's here, he's one move too late. Ah, man, I was so close. Okay. Let's pull up a game between. I don't know, do I have Ding? Nakamura and. Nakamura lost today to they haven't recorded it yet. Let me see if let's see if they've recorded any of the Ding Lauren games yet. Nothing yet. Interesting. Okay. We'll look at a French game that Ding played. So we'll see how that worked. It was a classic burn variation. Oops, sorry, I have to enlarge the board. It's about 10 years ago, this game. Oops, sorry, Ding is black. He's keeping the tension in the wings. That prevents B4. This move prevents B4 because B4 would be played, then he wins a pawn. Or he could play this, then win actually a pawn B that way. So there's a couple ways. Takes. Bishop C6. Assholes. Rook A E1. He takes, which pins the knight to the queen, but he can actually jump out of the pin. Attack of the queen. It looks tempting to play this here. I know you're thinking. Then that happens, and then you have this. And Ding's only up one pawn. He's down actually two pawns. So that's why I played the queen here. Now this is a threat because that can't be played. So bishop has to retreat back. Right there. Takes. And of course if he grabs there, then he loses there. So he has what white's trying to keep the the attack going, but it's not gonna work. Now Ding switches to G2. The queen goes there. Now he blocks, and now the bishop's free to roam. Slowly wiggling his queen into there. Now the queen could actually potentially come here, and then it's game, set, and match. Because if he tries up here, you have check, and if he comes up there, you actually have checkmate, which is a pretty nice checkmate. Gotta love that one. Let's see if there's any good ones with Ding. Another good French. Ooh, this is Kamsky versus Ding. Ask not for whom the bell tolls. Must have gotten a nickname. Chomsky's white, and this is the Steinitz variation. you take a look, it was actually in God's favor for a while, and then at around move 28's when God fell apart. Let me get a sip and then we'll continue. C3, knight f, a5, classic Steinitz. Castles, and then f6. So now Ding got all of his breaks in. He got this break in. So now it's black. Let's see what black can do with the breaks. And he's not. See how the supers don't rush it? There's no reason to rush it. Ding noticed a weakness on b2, so he just moved his queen to b6, and the king's safe. So first he opens up with f takes e5, which is actually a really smart way to do it, and then takes. D takes e5. Now rook d8. This is going to allow the knight to go slip back to d8, or no, f8, and then prepare potentially for the infiltration, or maybe something like this. You never know. This, and then that. Shabich. Wow, he goes smashing through right away. Interesting. Makes sense though if you want to think about it, because if he takes, knight takes, then you got a bishop there, and the queen's in deep trouble. He can't take, I'll show you. If he takes, knight takes. Bishop there, and the queen's lost. That was a really subtle tactic by Ding. Nice. D5, so he just pushes onward. Now Ding is now if the queen takes here, then you have knight takes with a discovery on the queen. So when the queen moves back, then you have check, king moves there, knight takes, king takes, pawn, check, and you have this right here, so the king has to come over there, and then you can actually bring the queen in and potentially mate with the queen, and you'd have to watch that mate there by playing something like that, and then queen here, and even pawn push might be playable, but there's a lot of play in that line. D8. A4. B5 was dubious. Castles, bishop b7, rook a2, b4, c4, knight a5. This actually is an interesting move because after takes, queen takes, Ding's opened up three pass pawns and a tremendous attack to boot with here and there. Yep. C6. That was the mistake. Bishop, the best move would have been taken here, here, there. And it's about an equal game. This loses though on the spot because takes. If you take here, then Ding has mate on h1. This time, if takes here, I'm thinking knight takes. And if the, not that moves, but if the queen moves, knight takes, rook takes. Bishop, or potentially maybe just swinging the other rook over. Now you're attacking there three times. So even if you played there, you could just move there. And with that, and everything's pinned. That's pinned there. That's pinned. That's pinned here. That's pinned. It's like, what isn't pinned in that line? There's all the pins that we talked about. We'll do some puzzles now. So let's do it. That was fun to go over some of the French defense. Okay. Let's do it to it. Queen check, or takes, that's mate, double check mate. Thank you. Rook takes bishop. King takes, and then that's. Oh man, I should have. Am I missing? I didn't even check if there's a mate. I might have set it up wrong. Oh. Wow, that was subtle. Removing the knight to mate. Oh, wow. That's nice. That was a nice one. Knight takes. Knight takes. So that's probably not the best. Let's try rook check. Rook. And that's mate. So queen check check. There's mate. Excuse me. Three more. Thank you. Check. That's me. He's actually forced to do that, so. Two more now. We can do this. Yes, we can. I serve the Lord. So let's do this. Sometimes a good hymn, I mean a good hum, always makes the time go by, and it makes the working fun. So if you have like a good hymn that honors the Lord by, or hum, sorry, then do it. But make sure it's good. And we have to always make sure that we are responsible chess players too. Let's see here. Okay. We got this. Okay. After this, one more. Try to wiggle in. And this actually forces the pawn to take, and then we just come back to h4 and it's checkmate. That was a pretty cool little wiggle. And yeah, let's say that he doesn't, after this, let's say he doesn't do anything, let's say he moves a bishop here, that's mate. Let's say that he tries king, actually king can't move, tries attacking there, that's mate. So anything else would be mate there. So let's do it to it. One more, my friends. Good. It's black to move. Mate in two. Check here. If we take there, queen takes, and bishop b5 is a mate, so we will stop here. wanted to thank you all for logging on, participating. Congrats, we got to go over 2 Dane games. Maybe tomorrow they'll have those games posted. And then we'll get to go over, we'll get to see the game that Dane defeated, I believe it was Geary, and that Napa, I hope I'm saying it right, actually defeated Hikaru Nakamura, so we'll go over those tomorrow. Gotta remember though, every day, put time in, no matter how you feel, and always have fun doing chess, and remember to use it to honor the Lord Jesus, basically study so that you can show yourself approved unto the Lord, and have fun. I always think of the Bruce Lee saying that he goes, there are no limits, there are plateaus, and you must not stay there, you must go beyond the plateau. That's kind of where we are right now. We have to go beyond our plateau. We did get to 35 or 34, I believe, which put us on the survivalist 24th in the world, so that's cool. We just gotta be able to see those subtle nuances, take our time, and build up on that. And that just comes with practice and just doing. But one thing you have to have is confidence. That's why Tom Thumb Thumb told Tango that, you know what, treasure your victories, you treasure those times when you win, learn from your losses, learn from the times that you lose, and remember that mistakes are part of learning, do not define you. It's how you handle the mistake that defines you as a chess player and a person. It's not where you started, it's where you finish that matters. Because there are 2 kings, King David and King Saul. One started out really good and ended really bad. That was King Saul. David started out as a lonely shepherd boy who tended the field, defeated a giant, got hunted by King Saul. And so if you looked at throughout his life, it was like, man, he didn't get to be king till he was like a little bit older. But when he was king, he honored the Lord, and he got to be named man after God's own heart. And it's not that he was perfect or in any way, because he did a lot of silly and foolish things like we all do. But he was constantly striving to honor the Lord with the gifts that he's given. And that's how we have to be too. I'll leave you with that. And as Wesley So says, through the Lord Jesus, as I say, God bless, and I'll see you next time on Chess Cruncher TV. Have a blessed morning, afternoon, and evening. The Lord will, and I'll be back on tomorrow. It will keep pushing forward and doing good. Remember, though, the Chess Cruncher, Team Chess Cruncher motto is hanging up your coats, hanging up your hats, sitting down and studying when most won't. Team Chess Cruncher does, and that makes all the difference. So remember what Hannibal Smith said, forcing moves are the vital, the backbone. And I kept forgetting to do the last thing, but when those 4C moves work, we get to say this: I love it when a plan comes together. But remember, if the 4C moves are brought on you and you either lose or draw, take it home, find out what happened, and then next time you can do the 4C moves and then inside say, I love it when a plan comes together. So either way, have fun, hoorah, be blessed, receive the Lord Jesus as Lord and Savior always, and remember, He's the way, the truth, and the life, okay? So, and ask the Holy Spirit to teach you all things, but you have to do your part too. So be blessed, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.